Please come sit down.
Why?
Because that's the message. All right, everyone is going to be at the carpet in 10, in 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I will throw them in the trash if you do not get to the carpet. All right, friends, let's check our schedule really fast. Oh, if you have a book, please put them in the bin. And Athena Jane, when we're getting ready to start, that's not when you go get a book. Thank you. All right, let's look at our schedule. Did we have integrity?
Yes.
Yes, let's put that over. Did we have foundation?
Yes.
Did we have enhancement?
Yes.
Did we have snap?
Yes.
All right, now we're going to have some reading and vocabulary time. Just like Miss Richards teaches in our classroom some days, Miss Simpson is here to teach you today for reading and vocabulary time. She'll also be here during the rest of our school day to observe. That was a special vocabulary word. Does anybody remember what observe means? Addison.
You look at it and you know where it is.
And you watch closely to what? Learn. Right. So Miss Simpson is here to watch Miss Brander closely to learn how to become a
teacher.
And I don't know all the things. So I'm not an expert, but I am doing my absolute best to teach you guys every day. So Miss Simpson is learning from myself. And we are learning from Miss Simpson. Okay? All right. She is. And that's okay. Everybody comes in different shapes and sizes. Okay. Thank you. When Miss Simpson is teaching, your bubbles are going to be in. If she asks you a question, you are going to raise your
hand.
If she does not call on you, are you going to talk?
No.
You're
going to wait until she gives you permission to speak.
Exactly. So if she does not point to you or if she does not say your name, then you do not have permission to speak. Okay, remember, Miss Simpson's teacher, her professor, is watching to see how well she can teach and is teaching. So you guys have to be on your best behavior because she's also watching to see, is Miss Bradner's kid, are they really good at being in kindergarten? Are they really almost ready for first grade? So it's going to be your job to show her that you are, okay? All right, Miss Simpson, did I forget anything?
No, I think I'm
good to go. Yeah. All right, did you want me to start or is it starting?
It already started.
Perfect. All right. All right.
We'll come back to it, I promise. All right. So I know all of you have been reading all these super fun books this semester and different types of books. Last week, I read a fairy tale because I love reading. Do you want to be like fairy tales?
Yeah.
Fairy tales, yeah. But yesterday, I read a book about a tiger because I wanted to learn more about tigers. Does anyone like tigers in here?
Yeah.
Me too. So sometimes I want to read to do different things. Sometimes I just want to read a funny story, and sometimes I want to read because I want to learn more about something. I want each of you to turn to a partner and talk about what you think fiction is.
Turn to someone sitting close to you and talk to them about what you think fiction is.
Five, four, three, two, someone share what their partner told them?
Oh, nice hands. Yes. Good for you.
She likes tigers? Okay.
Okay.
Can someone tell me what their partner told them about what they think fiction is? Yes. Okay, fantasy. That is an example of fiction. That's a great one. What about you? A jaguar? Could it be a story about a jaguar? Maybe that's made up? Yeah.
Not made up.
Not made up. Okay. Yeah.
Baby and a mommy duck.
Baby and a mommy duck. Yeah, that's a great one. And one more, I guess.
My partner said that she thinks it's real.
Okay. So now I want you to do the same thing, turn to the same partner, and talk about what you think nonfiction is.
It's not real.
I have some examples.
Sorry, I just wanted to make sure we were still recording here. You'll get to share.
Nonfiction. Someone I didn't hear from last time.
Aaliyah. It was Aaliyah's turn.
Okay.
Nonfiction.
Nonfiction. All right.
It's real.
Yeah.
Not real.
Not real. Okay.
She thought about it.
Okay, we have some great and interesting guesses here.
All right, let's see.
All right, so this is what we're going to learn about today. I'm going to say this for you guys, and I want everyone to say it together with me. I can identify whether a text is fiction or nonfiction.
I can identify whether a text is fiction or nonfiction.
Great job. All right. So fictional texts are texts that are made up by an author.
Oh,
and
my friend.
True.
Your bubbles need to be in.
Can someone tell me something they see about this picture that's talking about fiction? Yes. A unicorn, so that is a creature that's not real, so maybe fiction is something that's made up. Yes? A butterfly with a pencil. Can butterflies hold pencils?
No.
No, so this can't be a real story. Yes. A castle, right? You see a lot of castles in fairy tales, which are an example of fiction. Does anyone? You saw castles? There can be real castles too. There definitely can be. Yeah, a green bear. So, has anyone read a fiction book recently that they loved, or a fairy tale? Do you have a favorite book? Yes.
My favorite book is...
That's okay. Yeah.
If you're ready to read, then you're ready to
read. Your horse book? Okay. And one more. Yes. Okay. And so, this is a book that I chose. It's a fiction book. Has anyone ever read this one before?
Yeah!
How's the type? So this story is about cows that are using a computer. Do cows use a computer?
No!
So this must be a fiction story because it's funny to read, so we could read it because we want something to laugh at, but it's not something that's actually based off of real life, right?
No.
No. Yes?
I also call
fairy book? Yeah, that's a great fiction book.
I'm not in my fairy
book. Yeah, that's a great one.
Because I love fairy
books. Okay, what was your book from earlier?
Baby
Jesus. Oh, yeah, that's a great book.
Baby
Yeah.
We also had a camper that has all books in it, and we came getting stuff from the library, and now we got a lot more books.
Oh, I love books. All right, and now we're going to look at nonfiction.
That means real.
Yeah, so nonfiction texts teach, inform, and explain real things. What do we see here in this picture? It's about nonfiction.
Raise your hand.
Yes, in the blue shirt.
Junior.
The stones.
The stones. So we might be learning about rocks, which is something in nature. Yes. The butterfly. So that's a picture of a real butterfly. The other one was a butterfly that was drawn and holding a pencil. So that was not a real butterfly, but this one is. Yes. The statue of Abe Lincoln. That's a great job. That is Abraham Lincoln. That was one of our presidents. Yes. An apple, that's a real food, right? So, does anyone have a nonfiction book that they've been reading recently that they loved? Yes. Jack and the Beanstalk. So, that would actually be a good example of a fiction book, mm-hmm. but that's a great one because it's not a real story. Yes.
A bunny that is mean.
Okay, so this is a nonfiction book that I thought was really cute and interesting because I wanted to learn about pandas.
Pandas are real.
Pandas are real. So if we look at this cover, we can look at the fact that there's a real picture on there. Yes.
To the office.
I do. I actually have a picture of that book over there. It's your favorite book? About real pandas. So this would be a book that we would read if we want to learn more about pandas and maybe what they eat or where they live. So I'm going to put both of these up so we can compare the two. Does someone know a difference between fiction and nonfiction? How are they different? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, in fiction we might see a lot of drawings, but in nonfiction we might see real pictures. So we can look at them side by side right now. Can I get one more?
Did you know my mom got me a blue dress?
Oh, but Athena, remember, she just asked the difference between fiction and nonfiction.
All right.
Thank you.
A short video that I'm going to show you guys, and then we're going to talk about it.
Oh, I see that my friends at table two are being very quiet. Thank you. If you want to make it bigger, Miss Jenkins, you can do that.
I saw them.
Thank you.
Can someone tell me about the two videos that we just saw? Yes.
Nonfiction and fiction.
Nonfiction and fiction? Do you know which one was fiction? Somebody else? Yes, Junior?
The first one was fantasy and the second one was nonfiction.
Nonfiction? Okay, so how do we know that the first one was a fiction movie?
The pink ones
are talking. Your dad likes pink ones? Okay, that's great. Yes?
Because penguins don't talk.
That's right.
And
penguins
are birds that fly. Penguins are birds that cannot fly.
They're the only flightless
bird. I think that's that and
But I love how you said that penguins can't talk. So if the penguins are talking in that movie, then it can't be a real story. What's another thing about that movie that we just saw that makes it fiction?
Happy Feet is a movie.
Okay, so penguins actually can swim, but something that they were doing in the video, they were dancing. So we don't normally see penguins talking and dancing, do we? No, I don't think we do. So that would be fiction. Can someone tell me about the second video that we watched? Yes.
That was they
made
babies. They don't have hair on
stuff. They don't have hair on stuff? Yes. The seals, maybe?
Yeah, probably seals.
Yes.
I watched a different one that was, there was a lot in a line and they talked.
Yeah.
All of them talked. And three of them saw egg growing down, that they went down and then some animals tried to attack them.
Uh-huh.
And then they finally got somewhat safe, and then they lost their way home. So.
Yeah.
And then the baby cracked, and then they went somewhere to get a bag of chips.
That sounds like a great story. Thank you for sharing that. Okay. Yeah. So something that I noticed during that second video was that they were real.
My friends. Thank you.
is that they were real pictures and videos. So someone actually took those of real life penguins, which makes it nonfiction. So something about both of these videos is even though they were about the same topic, they were both about penguins, one of them was a real story and one of them was a made up story. So we would watch each of those for different reasons. We might watch Happy Feet, the first one, because we want to laugh and we want to listen to penguins talk and dance. And we might watch the second one because we want to learn more about penguins and their natural habitat. And it's cute. All right. So now I'm going to have you all go to your tables and we're going to do a group activity. So I'm going to pass out a picture of a book cover to each group. And I want you guys to carefully look at it and decide as a group whether it's fiction or nonfiction based on the cover. Yes, so you're going to each get a picture as a group, and I want you to think really hard about why and what about the cover makes this fiction or nonfiction, okay? All right, everybody go to their tables, please.
Walk, please.
Why can't I see your
feet? I see some feet right there.
I think it's far with
it. It's in the middle
here. I thought it was something else.
It's in the middle.
Yeah. What did you look at to figure it out?
The words.
The words? Because what about the words?
Because it's when
Phil's
at school.
And do bears go to school?
No.
No, bears don't go to school. Great job, guys.
But I haven't.
I love that you used the title to figure it out.
Not.
All right, table two, please. Alright, let's show the book cover that you guys had. I Don't Want to Be a Frog. Now, what did you guys decide
it's
this
not
was?
Not fake. It's fake.
Not it's fake. Fake, so what is not real?
The picture, because
we okay, so would that be fiction or nonfiction?
Not real. Not real.
Not real? So, not real is fiction.
Only frogs can be real.
Okay, and you guys. Can you guys share with everybody how you figured that out?
Because the frog is standing up.
The frog's standing up, okay.
And look, there's something like this.
Please move, sweetie. Thank you.
All right.
By the trash can.
Thank you. You guys can have a seat. Table three.
Table three. Where's my way up?
Table three, what book did you have?
We had
Duck for President. So did you guys decide that this was fiction or nonfiction?
Nonfiction.
Fiction? Okay, now how did you decide that it was fiction?
Because a duck can't be president.
Duck can't be president? Great, so you use the title.
Because they can't even talk.
They can't talk? Did you guys look at the picture?
They only say, come on.
Wow. Did you look at the picture to think about it?
Yeah.
Is it a real picture?
No.
No. So this is a fiction book. Great job, guys. Thank you for sharing. You can have a seat.
Thank you, table three.
Thank you, table three. Has everybody gone, or is there one more table? Okay, table five.
Table five.
All right, can I have everybody's attention for table five? Everybody listening to their book? All right, table five, what book did you have?
We had the angry dragon.
Okay, and now did you decide this was fiction or nonfiction?
It's fiction, because it's not real.
Fiction? How did you know that it's not real?
Dragons are real. Picture and dragons are real.
And you looked at the picture? Great job. You used both to figure it out. All right, you guys can have a seat. So,
nice job, Table 5.
Great job, everybody. Thank you for sharing. You guys did a great job at using both the title and the picture to figure out whether it was fiction or nonfiction. So I'm gonna have everybody go back to their tables, and this next activity we're gonna do by ourselves. So have a seat.
Yes, I'll take the
everybody to grab a pencil and a glue stick. Based off of what we just learned about fiction and nonfiction, use your brains to figure out if it's real or not real. And I'll be walking around to help you guys. Yes, everything is real. I will grab you guys scissors.
I'm going to write my name on this pencil.
All
right, friends, you should have scissors in your cubbies that you may use.
I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. Me too. I almost cut my hair off with scissors.
Abe is just a character.
Stuff to the back table.
Hi. Good job.
Give ourselves a little pat on the back. Good job.
I can't do that.